I would like to present our results on kernelization for enumeration problems, which we applied to the enumeration of matching cuts in undirected graphs. I am Christian Komusiewicz from the University of Marburg, and this is joint work with Peter Golovac from University of Bergen, Dieter Kratsch from Université de Lorraine, and Bang Le from University of Rostock. This work is dedicated to our co-author Dieter Kratsch, who very sadly passed away shortly after the submission of this work. Dieter actually initiated this work, and without him this paper would not exist. Enumeration problems are one main class of computational problems. And in general terms, the task is for a given input X to list a set of objects that fulfill some desired properties. And we will call this set of objects the solutions of X, and denoted by this sol of X. There are famous examples for these problems. For example, to enumerate all maximal cliques of a graph, which has the famous Born-Kerbosch algorithm, or to enumerate all minimal hitting sets of a hypergraph, or alternatively of a set family, and also to enumerate all satisfying assignments of a Boolean formula is a very famous enumeration problem. There is a slight difference in these problems that I mentioned here. For two of these problems, for these two, it's easy to decide whether there's at least one solution. And for the other two, where we are looking for satisfying assignments or for minimal hitting sets that fulfill some upper bound on the size, it's NP hard to decide whether there's at least one solution. In practice, enumeration problems can occur in both cases, so where we have a hard decision problem or an easy underlying decision problem. Formally, we can define enumeration problems as pairs of a standard decision problem L, so some decidable language L, and a function sol, which maps each instance to its solutions. And this function should have the property that it's finite for every x, and that sol is non-empty if and only if the instance x is a yes instance of the corresponding decision problem. When we have such an enumeration problem, the task is to obtain an algorithm that outputs the set sol of x without any duplicates and in a finite number of steps. And more precisely, we would like to have efficient enumeration algorithms. And the best thing we would hope for is to have polynomial time enumeration algorithms. Very often this is not possible because the number of solutions is exponential in the input size. And then one way to circumvent this problem would be to ask for polynomial delay algorithms, where we allow a polynomial running time between the output of consecutive solutions. So the algorithm lists all solutions one by one, and then the time between two solutions is bounded by a polynomial in the input size. This is one of the standard notions of efficiency in enumeration algorithms. And a consequence of a polynomial delay algorithm is that if you have a polynomial delay algorithm, you also have an algorithm that is output sensitive. That is, it has polynomial running time in input and output size. Now, as we've seen before, there can be problems where the decision version is not solvable in polynomial time, and then we cannot hope for polynomial delay algorithms. And one way to circumvent this is parameterization. So our enumeration problem now additionally has a parameter, and we allow larger running time for our enumeration algorithms. For example, we could say that we want FPT enumeration algorithms, which have an FPT running time in total, or we could allow FPT delay algorithms where the delay between consecutive solutions is polynomial. And the idea, of course, is that whenever the parameter kappa is small, then this algorithm will be fast, even if the problem in general is very hard. Now, a main technique for the design of FPT algorithm is kernelization, where we want to have an algorithm that takes a large instance X and transforms it in polynomial time into a small equivalent instance Y. And now for enumeration problems, we need to think about what it means to be equivalent. And here one could roughly say that we would expect Y to essentially contain the solutions of the input instance X. So first definition that captured this idea was the notion of full kernels, where we want that the kernel Y has a set of solutions, say call them S1 till ST. So this is the solution set of Y, and we want that this is the same as the solution set of X. So this is a very strict definition. For example, one can see that we constrain our solutions to be of size at most some function of the parameter with this definition. Another somewhat related definition was given for satisfiability problems. These are loss-free kernels where the kernel should have a variable set that contains all satisfying assignments. A more general definition of kernelization for enumeration problems was given by Grenu and others recently. This kernelization concept is more flexible, and it consists of two algorithms. So the first algorithm is our standard kernelization algorithm, which takes the input instance X and maps it to a small instance Y. So we have this size bound guarantee that the size of Y and plus the parameter of Y is bounded in a function of the parameter of X. Now the second component of this kernelization is a solution lifting algorithm. So this is called solution lifting. And this is an algorithm that takes us from the solutions of the kernel to the solutions of our input instance X. So this algorithm takes a solution of the kernel Y as input plus the input instance X and the kernel instance Y, and enumerates with FPT delay a set of solutions S1 for the instance, for the solution S1. And so this algorithm should work with this FPT delay running time for every solution of the kernel Y. And the solutions that you would produce if you run this algorithm for every solution of Y, they should give a partition of the solutions of X. So we do not miss a solution of X this way, and we do not have duplicate output. Now this definition is more flexible than the full kernels, because We can use this solution lifting algorithm, for example, to extend the solutions of y to make them longer if they have a size that is not bounded by the parameter. We found that for our studies, this definition was a bit too powerful, because allowing FPT delay makes the size of the kernel, the instance y, a bit less interesting. It can be very easy to show kernels of constant size for some problems when you have FPT delay in the solution lifting. So instead of allowing FPT delay, we allow either polynomial time solution lifting algorithms or polynomial delay solution lifting algorithms. And we call the two resulting notions of enumeration kernelization fully polynomial enumeration kernels and polynomial delay enumeration kernels. The term fully polynomial just means that all the algorithms have polynomial running time. Now our first result for these two new versions of enumeration kernelization is that they capture very naturally what we would expect from a kernel. Namely that if we have an FPT enumeration algorithm, then we want to have a fully polynomial enumeration kernel and vice versa. Yes. So the fully polynomial enumeration kernels correspond to the standard kernels for decision problems, where the problem is FPT if and only if it has a kernel. Then we get the same correspondence for delay algorithms. So we get an FPT delay algorithm if and only if we have a polynomial delay enumeration kernel. So this is the first part of this correspondence between kernels and efficient enumeration algorithms. And the second part, and this is where we differ a bit from the previous definition, we show that we can get kernels of constant size if and only if the enumeration problems can be solved in polynomial time. So this is for fully polynomial enumeration kernels. And if we talk about polynomial delay enumeration kernels, then they have constant size if and only if the enumeration problem has a polynomial delay algorithm. So this is our general contribution here. And we believe that these two new versions fill a small gap in the landscape of enumeration kernelization, but that this is an important gap, and that in particular restricting the solution lifting algorithms somehow makes these kernelization concepts more relevant, because with restricted solution lifting, we can still think of the kernel as representing all of the solutions in a compact way. We will now apply these concepts to the problem of enumerating matching cuts. This is a very natural graph problem, where we want to find a particular type of cuts. So a cut in a graph is a two partition of the vertex set. That's A and B. And we are interested in the edges that cross the cut. So these are called edge cuts. And we want to find an edge cut which is also a matching. So in this example, the edge cut is not a matching. Whereas this cut and the corresponding edge cut are matching. We are interested in three enumeration problems for matching cuts. We want to find all matching cuts of a graph, or all inclusion minimal matching cuts, or all inclusion maximal matching cuts. So these are these three problems. And for our purposes, these matching cut enumeration problems are interesting because already the decision problem is NP-hard. And what this shows us is that there cannot be polynomial delay enumeration algorithms unless P equals NP. So, and as a consequence, it makes sense to study parameterized versions of this matching cut enumeration problems. We consider several structural parameters for the input graph G, and I will present the results for the vertex cover number. We can make some observations based on very simple example about which type of kernels we may expect for the enumeration problems. In the first observation, that we want to make is for minimal matching cuts. If we think about a star with n leaves, then every edge of the star is a minimal matching cut. The star itself has a vertex cover number of 1. It's sufficient to choose the center of the star. And this shows us that we cannot enumerate all minimal matching cuts in a running time that depends only on the parameter. And as a consequence, we cannot expect to have a full kernel. So full kernelization is too strict for this problem and parameter. We can make a related observation for the problems of enumerating matching cuts and maximal matching cuts. If we consider a graph that consists of k disjoint stars, and these stars have all the same size, n over k, then the number of matching cuts is n over k to the k, and the number of maximum matching cuts is almost the same, n over k minus 1 to the k, and the vertex cover number of this graph is k. So as a consequence, we can see that there cannot be a fully polynomial enumeration kernel for these two problems when the parameter is the vertex cover number, simply because we cannot have an FPT enumeration algorithm because the number of solutions is too large. So it's not bounded in a function where the exponential part depends only on the parameter. And our results are that we will get for each of these problems the next best kernelization. So we will not get a full kernel, but we will get a fully polynomial enumeration kernel. And we will not get a fully polynomial enumeration kernel, but a polynomial delay enumeration kernel. So now I would like to briefly describe the enumeration kernelization, which consists of two parts, the standard kernelization and the solution drifting. And now the first part is to compute an approximate vertex cover X. The remaining vertices form an independent set I, which we further partition into those vertices of degree 0, degree 1, and degree 2. And now we label the vertices in I as follows. We mark one vertex of I0, then for each vertex in the vertex cover X, we mark exactly one neighbor in I1, it has one, and then for each pair of vertices in the vertex cover, we mark up to three common neighbors in I2. The remaining vertices in I will be deleted, and this gives us our kernel H. And it's not so hard to see that the number of vertices in H is roughly k squared. The bottlenecks are the vertices in I2. This kernel is roughly the same as the kernel for the decision problem. And the idea behind this marking in I2 is that if we have more than three common neighbors, then all the common neighbors and the two vertices x and y will be on the same side of a matching cut. Now the next part is the solution lifting, which enumerates a set of matching cuts for each matching cut of the kernel H. And now there are two main cases here. One is that the matching cut does not contain any edges between X and I1. In this case, we simply output the matching cut itself. And the other one is that the matching cut contains an edge between X and I1, for example, this edge. And now, because we are looking at minimal matching cuts, we see that it cannot contain anything else. And then we want to enumerate all matching cuts which are the same or which are similar to this one. And these will be the matching cuts which have the same vertex in X and a different neighbor in I1, or the same. Okay, so for this red one, we have three matching cuts that we output: the green one, the blue one, and the pink one. So these will be considered in some sense equivalent, and then we need to show that this procedure actually finds all matching cuts of G and does not output duplicate ones. This is then part of the proof for this algorithm. For the enumeration of maximal matching cuts, of all matching cuts, the kernelization is the same, but the solution lifting is different. And the main difference is that we can now have the case that the matching cut contains edges between several vertices of X and their neighbors in I1. And now all matching cuts are equivalent if they contain edges for the same stars between X and I1. So this matching cut, for example, would be equivalent to the red matching cut. And now we can find or enumerate all of these equivalent matching cuts by cycling through the sets of neighbors of the vertices in X that they have in I1. And this can be done with a branching algorithm that has polynomial delay. And altogether, we get a polynomial delay enumeration kernel for these two problems. We have obtained fully polynomial and polynomial delay enumeration kernels also for further parameters. And we also obtained a bound on the number of matching cuts in n vertex graphs. And we think that the topic has a lot of potential for interesting results in the future. One thing is one could look at further parameters for matching cut, for example, the feedback vertex set number. But maybe more important would be to consider further problems that are different from a matching cut, and to try to apply these types of kernelization for these problems. And final idea for future work would be to come up with a lower bound framework that is based on complexity theoretic considerations and can give additional results over the ones that we get from combinatorial bounds on the number of solutions.